Act 1. Two singers on stage, one younger, YG, one older, OG, both dressed in 1960s and 1970s style clothes, though nothing flamboyant. Stage is simple, a five-piece band in the background with two singers up front, both playing acoustic guitars with fixed mic stands. Set is black drapes with three video screens placed artfully upstage. Lights up. Video montage of 1940s, 1950s, rural Canada, mixed with melodies of some of the more well-known songs, gradually transitioning into an onstage version of
In the Early Morning Rain, with a dollar in my head, with an aching in my heart, in my pockets full of sand. I'm a long way from home, Lord, I miss my loved one so. In the early morning rain, with no place to go, out on runway number 9, Big 707 set to go. I'm stuck here in the grass, with a pain that ever grows. Now the liquor tasted good, and the women all were fast. Down there she goes, my friend, she'll be rolling down at last. Hear the mighty engines roar, see the silver wing on high. She's away in westward bow, far above the clouds she'll fly. Where the morning rain don't fall, and the sun always shines, she'll be flying over my home in about 3 hours' time. This old airport's got me down, it's no earthly good to me, and I'm stuck here on the ground, as cold and drunk as I can be. You can't jump a jet plane like you can a freight train, so I best be on my way in the early morning rain. You can't jump a jet plane like you can a freight train, so I best be on my way in the early morning rain.
Gordon Lightfoot was born in Orillia, Ontario, and he spent most of his life just an hour south in the city of Toronto. Orillia is on Lake Simcoe, and like those born next to the sea, the story of Gordon Lightfoot is the story of a man always looking to the horizons. He only moved away once. The one time he moved away, he wrote one of his best songs about standing at an airport watching the planes flying home, leaving him behind.
You can jump a jet plane like you can a freight train, so I best be on my way in the early morning rain.
Traveling, moving, leaving, and coming home. In the early days, Gordon Lightfoot was a restless man with a restless heart. Growing up in Orillia, he almost drowned playing on the ice, and right away he decided that he was destined for something important. He started performing early. His very first performance was back in grade school, singing an old music hall Irish song over the school PA. And the broad sweep of Canada, the wilderness, the open spaces, and the silences were calling to him. He first went to Los Angeles to try to make it big, but soon he was back in Ontario. There were too many things calling him home.
Well, I got my mail late last night, a letter from a girl who found the time to write to her lonesome boy somewhere in the night. She sent me a railroad ticket too, to take me to her loving arms in the big steel rail, gonna carry me home to the one I love. Well, I've been out here many long days, haven't found a place that I could call my home. Not a two-bit bed to lay my body on. I've been stood up, I've been shook down, I've been dragged into the sand, and the big steel rail gonna carry me home to the one I love. Well, I've been uptight most every night, walking along the streets of this old town. Not a friend around to tell my troubles to. My good old car, she done broke down, just I drove it into the ground. And the big steel rail gonna carry me home to the one I love. Well, I look over yonder across the plain, the big drive wheels are pounding along the ground. Gonna get on board and I'll be homeward bound. Now I ain't had a home-cooked meal, and Lord, I need one now. And the big steel rail gonna carry me home to the one I love. Well, here I am with my head in the sand, standing on the broad highway, would you give a ride to a lonesome boy who missed a train last night? I went in town for one last round and I gambled my ticket away. And the big steel rail won't carry me home to the one I love.
Those early years were tough. Lightfoot was not a natural performer. He was nervous and shy, but he had the gift of poetry and an ability to write from his soul in a way that could connect to the whole world. And he was trained. Unlike many folk singers of his day, Gordon could read and write music and was a fine singer and guitar player. All the pieces were there. There were two great threads in Gordon's life. The first was his love of the outdoors, the Great Lakes and wide open spaces. The other was women. Though he could be awkward and shy on stage, the ladies always loved him, and his life was marked by great loves and romantic turmoil, all of which he put into his songs. His first wife, Britta, was a beautiful young Swedish model, and though the marriage ultimately ended a decade later, they had two children together. And she inspired several of his greatest songs.
That's what you get for loving me. That's what you get for loving me. Everything you had is gone, as you can see. That's what you get for loving me. I ain't the kind to hang around with any new love that I've found. Cause moving in my stock and trade, I'm moving on. I won't think of you when I'm gone. So don't you shed a tear for me, cause I ain't the love you thought I'd be. I've got 100 more like you, so don't be blue. I'll have a thousand before I'm through. Now there you go, you cried again. Now there you go, you cried again. But then someday when your poor heart is on the mend, I just might pass this way again. That's what you get for loving me. That's what you get for loving me. Everything you had is gone, as you can see. That's what you get for loving me. That's what you get for loving me.
Despite the tensions in his home life that inspired that song, it became one of Gordon's biggest hits, and also became the song that launched his career into the stratosphere. It was recorded by dozens of other stars of the day. Even Elvis Presley covered the song. It got him a real record deal, high-powered management, and more. That period, and his marriage, brought out some of the worst in Gordon at a personal level. But as a writer, his troublesome marriage brought to life one of his most poignant lyrics in a song addressed to his wife. He laid out his heart in the classic Bitter Green.
Upon the bitter green she walked, the hills above the town echoed to her footsteps as soft as eiderdown, waiting for her master to kiss away her tears, waiting through the years. Bitter green, they called her, walking in the sun, loving everyone that she met. Bitter green, they called her, waiting in the sun, waiting for someone to take her hand. Some say he was a sailor who died away at sea. Some say he was a prisoner who never was set free. Lost upon the ocean, he died there in the mist, dreaming of her kiss. Bitter green, they called her, walking in the sun, loving everyone that she met. Bitter green, they called her, waiting in the sun, waiting for someone to take her home. But now the bitter green is gone, the hills have turned to rust. There comes a weary stranger, his tears fall in the dust, kneeling by the churchyard in the autumn mist, dreaming of a kiss. Bitter green, they called her, walking in the sun, loving everyone that she met. Bitter green, they called her, waiting in the sun, waiting for someone to take her hand. Bitter green, they called her, walking in the sun, loving everyone that she met. Bitter green, they called her, waiting in the sun, waiting for someone to take her hand.
Meanwhile, the mid-1960s saw Gordon come into his own as a performer. The success of his first album led to solo dates across the continent. Though he was shy and lacked confidence, Gordon knew his songs were good, and he knew he could play them well, so he stuck to what he knew. His marriage with Britta was a constant struggle. Alcohol had become a way of life for him, and though he strayed regularly, he also accused Britta of having an affair. Once again, he was able to turn turmoil in his personal life into a hit song.
It's all right for some, not all right for me, when the one that I'm loving slips around. You think it's fine to do things I cannot say, and you're doing it to me. Baby, can't you see that I know how it is?
I can see it in your eyes and feel it in the way you kiss my lips. I can hear it in your voice whenever we are talking. See what you believe in when his name is mentioned and I die. I can watch the way you walk, the way you talk, the way you close your eyes.
It's alright for some, not alright to be where the one that I'm loving can't be found. The city where we live might be quite large, but the circle is small. Why not tell us all, and then all of us will know.
I can see it in your eyes and feel it in the way you kiss my lips. I can hear it in your voice whenever we see what you believe in when his name is mentioned in the day. I can watch the way you walk, the way you talk, the way you close your eyes.
It's alright to live, not alright to lie when you come home and you can't say where you've been. Find a clue, things I cannot say, and you're doing it to me. Baby, can't you see that I know how it is?
I can see it in your eyes and feel it in the way you kiss my lips. I can hear it in your voice whenever we are talking. See what you believe in when his name is mentioned in the day. I can watch the way you walk, the way you talk, the way you close your eyes. I can see it in your eyes and feel it in the way you.
In 1966, he went on a streak. 7 albums in 7 years, roughly original songs, plus touring almost nonstop. How did he maintain this pace? It was a hectic pace indeed, but he paid a high price for it. He often toured alone in those days, and the quiet and shy man struggled with loneliness. Finally, in July of 1969, he left his family home and moved to another house he bought nearby. He took only a wicker chair and a table. Every day for months, alone and isolated, he wrote words and music, coffee and whiskey constantly at his side, melodies and lyrics pouring out of him. He wrote many of his greatest songs in this period, including the classic Sit Down, Young Stranger, where Gordon addresses a younger version of himself, yearning for the peace and security of the life he had left behind in Orillia.
I'm standing at the door with my head bound in my hands, not knowing where to sit, not knowing where I stand. My father looms above me, for him there is no rest. My mother's arms enfold me and hold me to her breast. They say you've been out a-wandering, they say you've traveled far. Sit down, young stranger, and tell us who you are. The room has all gone misty, my thoughts are all in spin. Sit down, young stranger, and tell us where you've been. Well, I've been up to the mountain, I've walked down by the sea. I never questioned no one, and no one questioned me. My love was given freely, and oft times was returned. I never came to borrow, I only came to learn. Sometimes it did get lonely, but it taught me how to cry. And laughter came too easy for life to pass me by. And I never had a dollar that I didn't earn with pride, 'cause I had a million daydreams to keep me satisfied. Gather daydreams, or will you gather wealth? How can you find your fortune when you cannot find yourself? My mother's eyes grow misty, there's a trembling in her hand. Sit down, young stranger, I do not understand. And will you try and tell us you've been too long at school? That knowledge is not needed, that power does not rule. That war is not the answer, that young men should not die. Sit down, young stranger, I wait for your reply. The answer is not easy, for souls are not reborn. To wear the crown of peace, you must wear the crown of thorns. If Jesus had a reason, I'm sure he would not tell. They treated him so badly, how could he wish them well? The parlor now is empty, there's nothing left to say. My father has departed, my mother's gone to pray. There's rockets in the meadows and ships out on the sea. The answer's in the forest, carved upon a tree. John loves Mary, does anyone love me?
His marriage to Britta became a daily struggle. The pressures of his growing fame, the constant demands on his time, his dependence on the bottle, and relentless ambition were just too much. In these years, the strains of country music, which often battles with traditional folk music in his writing, found flower. The country singer Marty Robbins heard Ribbon of Darkness and immediately knew the sweeping lines and notes would suit his crooner's voice.
Ribbon of darkness over me, since my true love walked out the door. Tears I never had before. Ribbon of darkness over me, clouds are gathering over my head, that chill the day and hide the sun, that shroud the night when day is done. Ribbon of darkness over me, rain is falling on the meadow, where once my love and I did lie. Now she is gone from the meadow, my love, goodbye. Ribbon of darkness over me, where once the world was young as spring, where flowers did bloom and birds would sing. Ribbon of darkness over me. In this cold room lying, don't wanna see no one but you. Lord, I wish I could be dying to forget you. How I wish your heart could see how mine just aches and breaks all day. Come on back and take away. Ribbon of darkness over me,
come on back and take away ribbon of darkness over me.
A master poet and songwriter, Gordon could find inspiration almost anywhere. The sight of swamp weeds waving in the wind created an analogy for the winding seasons of a relationship.
Pussy willows, cattails, soft winds and roses, rain pools in the woodland, water to my knees. Shivering, quivering, the warm breath of spring. Pussy willows, cattails, soft winds and roses. Catbirds and cornfields, daydreams together, riding on the roadside, the dust gets in your eyes. Beveling, disheveling, the summer nights can bring. Pussy willows, cattails, soft winds and roses. Slanted rays and colored days, stark blue horizons, naked limbs and wheat bins, hazy afternoons. Voicing, rejoicing, the wine cups do bring. Pussy willows, cattails, soft winds and roses. Harsh nights and candle lights, wood fires ablazing, soft lips and fingertips resting in my soul. Treasuring, remembering the promise of spring. Pussy willows, cattails, soft winds and roses.
In those quiet and reflective moments, Gordon found some of his finest lyrics. As the toll of his lifestyle began to wear on him, his thoughts turned to his parents. Though their lifestyle and values were far different from his own, Gordon treasured his upbringing in Orillia and always spoke well of their love and support. One morning, his coffee by his side, along with a newly tuned guitar and a blank sheet of paper, he heard his mother in his head, and he poured all her kind and knowing words into this song.
Go first in the world, go forth with your fears. Remember, a price must be paid. Be always too soon, be never too fast. At the time when all debts must be laid. Beware of the darkness, be kind to your children. Remember the woman who waits. And the house you live in will never fall down if you pity the stranger who stands at your gate. When you're caught by the gale and you're full under sail, beware of the dangers below. And the song that you sing, you should not be too sad, and be sure not to sing it too slow. Come in the face of all common disgraces and know what they're doing it for. And the house you live in will never fall down if you pity the stranger who stands at your door. When you're out on the road and feeling quite lost, consider the burden of things. And he who is wise will not criticize when other men fail. of the game. Beware of strange faces in dark, dingy places. Be careful while bending the law. And the house you live in will never fall down if you pity the stranger who stands at your door. When you're down in the dumps and not ready to deal, decide what it is that you need. Is it money or love? Is it learning to live? Or is it the mouth you must feed? Be known as a man who will always be candid on questions that do not relate. And the house you live in will never fall down if you pity the stranger stands at the gate. And the house you live in will never fall down if you pity the stranger stands at the gate.
But Gordon was not immune to the damage his life was causing to those around him, and his children were never far from his mind. As always, it was through his songs where he was at his most sincere and articulate. And throughout those years, he wrote songs for them, stories to reassure and comfort them in their own times of fear and doubt, like his Ode to Childhood.
When it's midnight on the meadow and the cats are in the shade, and the river tells a story at the window by my bed, if you listen very closely, be as quiet as you can. In the yard you'll hear him, it is the pony man. We're always there to greet him when he tumbles into town. He leads a string of ponies, some are white and some are brown. And they never seem to kick or bite, they only want to play. And they live on candy apples instead of oats and hay. And when we are assembled, he gives a soft command. And we climb aboard our ponies as in a row they stand. Then down the road we gallop and across the fields we fly. And soon we all go sailing off into the midnight sky. And as we gaily rock along beside a rippling sea, there's Tom and Dick and Sally and Mary Jo and me. And the pony man is leading, 'cause he's traveled here before. And he gives a hoop and a holler at Mr. Moon's front door. Then we stop to rest a while where the Soda River glides. Up to the slip comes a pirate ship to take us for a ride. And the pony man's the captain and the children are the crew. And we go in search of treasure and laugh the whole night through. And when the hold is filled with gold and the sails begin to strain, and the decks pile high with apple pie, we head for port again. Then down the whirling staircase, so swift our ponies fly. And we're safely in our beds again when the sunbeams kiss the sky. When it's midnight on the meadow and the cats are in the shade, and the river tells a story at the window by my bed, if you listen very closely, be as quiet as you can. In the yard you'll hear him, it is the pony man.
The marriage, like many of Gordon's relationships, ultimately came to an end. But amidst the wreckage of that relationship, great songs continued to emerge as he channeled his pain into new songs, including this sad and beautiful ode to lost love, a song so poignant Britta herself came to embrace it as her own. Laughing eyes and smiling face, it seems just to have the right of telling you with all my might, you're beautiful tonight, and I know that you will never stray, because you've been that way from day to day for such a long time.
At times I just don't know how you could be anything but beautiful. Think that I'm made for you, and you were made for me. And I know that I will never change. We've been friends, the rain or shine, for such a long, long time. Laughing eyes and smiling face, it seems so lucky just to have the right. Telling you with all my might, you're beautiful tonight. And I know that you will never stray, 'cause you've been that way from day to day for such a long, long time. When you hold me tight, how could life be anything but beautiful? Think that I was made for you, and you were made for me. And I know that I will never change. We've been friends, rain or shine, for such a long, long time. Well, I must say, it means so much to me to be the one who's telling you I'm telling you that you're beautiful.
For better or worse, his marriage to Britta came to define the decade for Gordon Lightfoot. It left him shattered emotionally and too fond of the whiskey bottle, but it also helped him find a well of creativity that led him to the lyrics of one of his greatest songs, a song so good he played it at every show for the rest of his life. Gordon himself once said it was a song about the failure of his marriage, but also a song about acceptance, acceptance of his failure, and accepting that he had to move on, ahead down the highway.
If you could read my mind, love, what a tale my thoughts could tell. Just like an old-time movie about a ghost from a wishing well. In a castle dark, or a fortress strong, with chains upon my feet. You know that ghost is me, and I will never be set free. As long as I'm a ghost you can't see. If I could read your mind, love, what a tale your thoughts could tell.
just like a paperback novel, the kind the drugstore sells. When you reach the part where the heartaches come, the hero would be me. Heroes often fail, and you won't read that book again, because the ending's just too hard to take. Like a movie star who gets burned in a three-way script, into number two, a movie queen to play the scene of bringing all the good things out in me. But for now, love, let's be real, I never thought I could act this way, and I've got to say that I just don't get it. I don't know where we went wrong, but the feeling's gone, and I just can't get it back. If you could read my mind, love, what a tale my thoughts could tell. Just like an old-time movie about a ghost from a wishing well, in a castle dark or a fortress strong, with chains upon my feet, the story's always in. If you read between the lines, you'll know that I'm just trying to understand the feelings that you left. Never thought I could feel this way, and I've got to say that I just don't get it. I don't know where we went wrong, but the feeling's gone, and I just can't get it back.
End of Act One.